The Prophet, he says, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, every Prophet in dunya, every Prophet was given one wish, one dua. In our modern, يعني, get out of jail free card. Anytime, any place, he puts it on the table with Allah, Allah answers. Nuh, when he put his card on the table, he said, oh Allah, destroy them. Allah sent rain from the heavens and from the earth. He left nothing behind. Isa, when he asked Allah, oh Allah, free me for what they intend on doing, Allah Azza wa Jal took him to the heavens and will return him back one day. But he used his card. And the Prophet says, every Nabi and every Prophet used their card in dunya except for me. You know, me personally, and I really have a sick mind. Because I can't help but ask. A Prophet of Allah, yani, why didn't you use your card in dunya? Why? All of the hardship, all of the trials and tribulations that you went through in your seerah, and you had the chance to use this card and save yourself and save your family from this hardship, yet you held on to it. Why? Are you concerned about yourself, Ya Rasulullah? Are you doubtful that you're not going to enter Jannah? Allah says, Al-Maqam Al-Mahmood has been promised to you. Why did you leave the card? Yani, what are you holding it on for? Are you concerned about your best friend Abu Bakr? What are you concerned about? May you said in the authentic hadith, every person who did me a favor, I paid back that favor, except for Abu Bakr. I physically can't pay him back. Allah will pay him back on the Day of Judgment. Who did you leave the card for? Who? Your daughter Fatima? Were you concerned about Fatima, Ya Rasulullah? You said in the authentic hadith, Fatima, you will be the queen of the women of Jannah. Who did you leave the card for? Your Sahaba? Allah says in Quran, I am pleased with them and they are pleased with me. Who did you leave the card for? Wallahi, help me, I'm struggling. I'm struggling to understand. Uhud, in the battle of Uhud, he watched his Sahaba die. He watched his beloved uncle Hamza, never mind he was killed. He was butchered, tortured. He ripped his liver out of his stomach, took a bite and spat it on the floor. When Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he seen his uncle Hamza, in narrations, Sahaba said, we never heard Rasulullah cry like he cried for his uncle Hamza. In narrations, he prayed janazah for his uncle 70 times. 70, 70 times he prayed janazah for his uncle Hamza. Until Jibreel came down and said, O Prophet of Allah, relax. It's been written on the arsh of Allah, Hamza Asad Allah wa Rasul. A Prophet of Allah, if you're so concerned and you're so worried, take out this card. Rayhalak ba'aman. Rayhalak Allah. Why you got every one of his children, imagine, his sons and his daughters, every one of them except for Fatima, every one of them died in his life. He buried every one of his children except for Fatima, who died 6 months later, and he knew she was going to die 6 months later. That if you're so worried and concerned, take out this card. Rayhalak ba'aman. He says, no, I held on to my card. For what? For who? He says, I held on to it for a day that will come when all of humanity will run to their father Adam. Imagine all of us, that day, 50,000 years long, the sun is 1 mile above your head, you're naked, barefooted, uncircumcised, where lust, confusion, darkness, heat, يَوْمَ يَفِرُّ الْمَرْءُ مِنْ أَخِيهِ وَأُمِّهِ. That day your mother, your father, your children, your wife, your husband, whatever the case is, everyone will run away from you. Everyone will disown you. People are lost and confused and no one knows where to go. He says, I left it for that day when humanity will run to Adam. And Adam, your father, the Prophet of Allah, will say, get away from me, nafsi, nafsi. I have my own problems today. Get away from me. Go to Ibrahim, go to Nuh, and humanity will run to Nuh and run to Ibrahim and run to Isa. He says, until eventually they will come to me. And that's the day I will go. I will prostrate before Allah Azza wa Jal. I will praise Him like He's never been praised before. And Allah Azza wa Jal will tell me, Irfa, raise your head on Muhammad, intercede and your intercession will be accepted. He says, on that day, at that moment, I will not ask for my daughter. I will not ask for my wives. I will not ask for my companions. That day I will turn to Allah and say, Ya Rabbi, Ummati, Ummati. My Rabb, my Ummah, have rahmah and mercy on my Ummah. All this hardship, and he could have saved himself. He refused to do it because he knew that there will come a people like you and I who will need every single bit of that card on the day of judgment. He said, I left it for that day when I stand before Allah.